Let me just make sure I'm online. Okay. Hello, I'm Alex from A.P.Ink. So today I'm going to be picking up where I left off yesterday. This week I'm working on an animal study of a squirrel. I believe this is a red squirrel. So today I'm going to try the best I can to recreate this guy as a pencil sketch. Let me just make sure that my phone is off. Okay, sorry. So yeah, I've got a piece of sketchbook paper, a 2H pencil, and some other pencils off to the side. So yeah, I'm gonna start with just trying to rough it out. So I'm just gonna get into this. Okay, so there's the reference. That's my version. Hopefully you can see that. So I'm gonna go over the 2H with B. pencil to darken the lines. Okay. So from here, I'm going to mostly switch back and forth between the 2H and the B to add detail. Before I get into too much detail, I'm gonna try and fix this nose. just adjusting some of the details. I think I'm making it worse. Okay, I think I just put it back to the way it was. Not intentionally. That I don't have the face right, the head shape right. Okay, getting into the detail. Okay, I do have charcoal pencils off to the side that I might come back in and pick up some of this pencil to deepen the tones. I want to try and hold off on using the charcoal pencils until last, just to stop from smearing charcoal all over. Hello. Yeah, more squirrels. Obviously, I'm not following, I'm not copying whatever it's nesting in because my focus is on the squirrel. That might be a cop out, but that's what I'm doing anyway. Thank you. Okay, so, with a kneaded eraser, I'm going to go in and pick up some of the darker tones here and replace it with a charcoal pencil. So I've got a neutral charcoal pencil. Okay, so just around here where the darker shadows come in, around here where the tail kind of wraps around the lower part, probably like the thigh or whatever, and then here, I'm going to transition that just so it's not like darkest and then pencil. So I'm going to try and darken the pencil some so it kind of makes more sense and it's not so blunt. So clearly there's way more detail on the tail than what I've done here. That's the one I ended on yesterday. That was this reference, which I didn't even get the shape right. Because looking at it here, it comes up over the head. Way more than what I drew. Yeah. There are people out there who have a lot more patience with this than I do. Like, I've seen people who, could almost photorealistic copy each individual hair. Mean, really, the whole point of me doing these studies is to try and improve my grasp on realism. But I'm also lazy, which doesn't help the process. Anyways, I don't know. I know I didn't quite get the features here. Like, the gap between where the top of the head is and the tail is way. I mean, it looks like they're touching. And I did try to bring the tail over. But I think I actually have the ear. Maybe too tall, or it's in the wrong position, because I couldn't get it to where the tail didn't overlap the ear more. I'm still not exactly sure how this tail is coming this way and then jets up this way. If it's because of the nest that it's in, or if there's another squirrel under this. I don't know, it just doesn't make sense to me. And I think, I don't know if that's a lip sticking out underneath the top cheek, or if that's like its tongue sticking out. Well, I mean, if this is like a baby squirrel, because with its curled up like this, no real indication on how big it is, but if this is like a nest or whatever, there could be more than one squirrel in there. I don't know. Like, I've seen chipmunks. They... At least the chipmunks I saw, they were they burrowed into the ground, and I think there was 5 or 6 of them in that hole. I don't know how they nest like that, like how big they burrowed. So it's possible that maybe there could be more than one. I don't know. I don't know anything about squirrels. I know chipmunks and squirrels aren't the same, but they're kind of the same. Anyways, I think I'm going to leave this here. Thanks, Asafkura, for hanging out. Hopefully you're doing well. Thank you to anybody else who watched or watches. I plan on being back tomorrow about 6:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time for anybody who would like to join me live. But other than that, enjoy the rest of your day. Thank you. Bye.